नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब दोस्तों। वर्कमॉप द्वारा शुरू की गई कहानियों की इस खास मुहिम में आप सभी का तहे दिल से स्वागत है। दोस्तों, ये एक ऐसी मुहिम है जो हम सभी को एक दूसरे से जोड़ती है। जी हाँ, अब तक कई लोग इस मुहिम का हिस्सा बने हैं जिन्होंने अपने जीवन के अनुभवों को, अपने विचारों को हमारे साथ साझा किया है और अपनी कहानी से देशवासियों को दी है एक नई प्रेरणा, एक नया संदेश। तो दोस्तों, कहानियों के इसी सिलसिले को आगे बढ़ाते हुए बढ़ते हैं आज की अगली कहानी की ओर। जी हाँ, ये कहानी है मालविका फुलवानी के जीवन के प्रेरक अनुभवों के बारे में। हेल्थ, वेलनेस एंड फिटनेस इंडस्ट्री में विगत कई वर्षों के अपने व्यापक अनुभव के साथ सेवाएं दे रही मालविका फुलवानी पेशे से एक अनुभवी क्लिनिकल डाइटिशियन होने के साथ साथ न्यूट्री जेनेटिक्स काउंसलर और एक सर्टिफाइड डायबिटीज एजुकेटर है। वर्तमान में ये नागपुर स्थित हेल्थीट्यूड नामक प्राइवेट प्रैक्टिस कंपनी में एक क्लिनिकल डाइटिशियन के रूप में अपनी बेहतरीन सेवाएं दे रही है। इनका जन्म और पालन पोषण नागपुर शहर में हुआ, वहीं से इन्होंने अपनी स्कूली शिक्षा भी प्राप्त की और फिर बायोटेक्नोलॉजी में स्नातक किया और डाइटेटिक्स में पीजी डिप्लोमा कोर्स किया। इसी दौरान जब इन्हें ये महसूस हुआ कि एक अच्छी डाइट लेना प्रत्येक व्यक्ति के लिए उतना ही जरूरी है जितना कि जीवन में बाकी दूसरी चीजें जरूरी है, ऐसे में क्लिनिकल न्यूट्रिशन में इनकी दिलचस्पी और ज्यादा बढ़ने लगी, क्योंकि अपने व्यक्तिगत अनुभव के बाद ये चाहती थी कि हर व्यक्ति को स्वस्थ और सुखी जीवन जीने के लिए संतुलित आहार लेने के लिए ये प्रेरित कर सके। ऐसे में इन्होंने अपनी एकेडमिक इंटर्नशिप पूरी करने के बाद न्यूट्रिशनिस्ट के रूप में अपनी सेवाएं देना प्रारंभ किया और अपने इस सफर को आगे बढ़ाया। आज ये अच्छी डाइट लेने के लिए ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों को जागरूक करते हुए उनकी स्वस्थ जीवन शैली में बदलाव लाने का प्रयास कर रही है और अपने इस पेशे से ये पूरी तरह संतुष्ट हैं और खुश भी हैं। तो दोस्तों, ये तो हुई मालविका फुलवानी के जीवन से जुड़ी कुछ खास बातें जो हमने अभी आप सभी के साथ साझा की। इनके जीवन के तमाम अनुभवों, इनके अब तक के पूरे सफर के बारे में विस्तार से जानने के लिए आइए अब सीधा मिलते हैं हमारी आज की खास मेहमान, एक अनुभवी क्लिनिकल डाइटिशियन, न्यूट्री जेनेटिक्स काउंसलर और एक सर्टिफाइड डायबिटीज एजुकेटर मालविका फुलवानी से, और इनके जीवन की ये प्रेरक कहानी सुनते हैं इनकी अपनी जुबानी।
हेलो, आई एम डायटिशियन मालविका फुलवानी फ्रॉम द सिटी ऑफ नागपुर इन महाराष्ट्र। I have been born and brought up in Nagpur with a joint family. We are 10 of us in the family. I am a clinical nutrition. I have done my post-graduation in dietetics and nutrition, worked with various hospitals in Bombay as well as Nagpur. Currently, I have started this company called Healthitude, which is a private practice company. As well, I am associated with two of the doctors in Nagpur. I give a diet to the people who have diseased conditions like coronary artery problems or diabetes, thyroid, PCOS. My specialization is in diabetes. I am a certified diabetes educator as well. Right from the childhood, I wanted to be a doctor. During 12th, I appeared for those entrance exams for MBBS, but I couldn't get through. So I took up a BSc in Biotechnology and Microbiology from Nagpur University, but it did not interest me much. I was looking for different other professions that could be taken up, and that's when I came across dietetics and nutrition. Dietetics and nutrition interested me for my own self because I have been a chubby kid since birth. So I thought rather than actually taking consultations from different dietitians, which I have already been doing until my BSc, let's help ourselves, if not anybody else. So I took up PG diploma in dietetics, studied and got through, got so much of knowledge about various diets and believe me, diet is not only for weight loss or weight gain. It is just one small pinch of part in diet. But diet in altogether is a big thing. It is a basic necessity for you and me, or for a baby that is conceived in a mother's womb till your last breath. So every minute, every second, you require energy, and the energy is from the diet. So, you know, that is what I did my master's. I went to Bombay to pursue my internship, and it's been 6 years that I've been working in this field. My biggest inspiration has been my teacher, Dr. Shakti Sharma, who has helped me through this journey, who actually brought me into this paramedical journey. And now I can say that long lost dream of becoming a doctor, I have reached somewhere. You know, working with patients gives me that that happiness, that feeling of content that yes, you wanted to be a doctor, but if not a doctor, at least you are one of those people who doctor require for your patient's consultation, for your patient's counseling. So yeah, that was what one of my that is how I got into this. In our profession, one thing that that every person comes come across, one challenge is, you know, in India, anybody who herself has lost a lot of weight, or these protein powders, they have their own 3 days course, 3 months course, and when they start giving diet plans, they don't have a basic degree of a basic science degree also. They are commerce students, they are art students, and they start giving diet plans. They start saying that we have lost weight, why can't you? And you know, they start giving those protein powders, those supplements which your body doesn't require. So the biggest challenge for any dietitian in India is to come across, or to actually be a better person than these quacks. We as a team became a foundation called Campaign Against Nutrition Quacks and Courses. And now it's been 3 years that this campaign is running against these quacks of different companies, the 3 days course, nutritionist. We are actually making awareness, spreading awareness that please consult a qualified dietitian rather than consulting a person who has very little knowledge of nutrition herself. And please do ask for those for the degree or for the proper reasons why a person has become a dietitian, or how is she eligible to give the diet. So that is how one of the challenges we as a team of dietitians have come across. Other challenges that I have come across is Nagpur was a tier 2 city, and here people have very less awareness of diet. And I have come across people who say diet, khana to sabhi khate hain. Why do you require a special dietitian to give a diet, and why do we require to pay them? Khana, sirf khana nahi khane ke liye paise dene ka kya matlab hai? And you know, very less awareness of importance of right nutrition. We have taken various education sessions at various other organizations, social organizations. Told people why nutrition is important, why diet need to be right, and why your regular food might not be right for you, and what proportion you should be eating. These sessions have helped me actually make good contacts, and it has helped me spread awareness amongst people. And now, post-COVID, it has become a little better scenario. People have actually started understanding the importance of immunity and how diet and nutrition helps in improving the immunity. So these are a few ways I have made these challenges a cakewalk for my life. My biggest inspiration, as I said earlier also, has been my teacher, my dietetics teacher Dr. Shakti Sharma. She actually counseled me to be a part, to participate in this course, to actually learn this course, and she has been an integral part of my dietetics journey. Other than that, I am inspired by a lot of people. I try to take few things from each one of the people I come across. I have had amazing mentors until now, be it during my BSc, be it during my internship in Fortis Mulun. My mentor there was amazing. She used to actually be that tough person to actually make me study, read. She used to come up with such questions that we used to read and keep ourselves updated with the new researches. And if it wouldn't have been for her, I wouldn't have had knowledge in critical care nutrition, that is the nutrition that you require while you are admitted in ICU. So she has been a motivator, a driving force. My doctor, Dr. Himanshu Patil, he's an endocrinologist in Nagpur. He is one of the driving force now. He tells me to keep myself updated with various researches. He keeps updating me, telling me about new researches that are coming in the field of endocrinology. He inspires me a lot. He's a self-made doctor. He has helped me actually be what I am today. So a lot of people, not one to remember now. I get inspired by a lot of people. Anything that I like, I get inspired by them. To become a dietitian, you require science degree basic with chemistry during your 12th and your BSc. Then you can do so anybody who thinks that commerce ke baad dietetics ho sakta hai, so again I'm saying it is a quack course. You cannot do that course because you need to know basic biology, basic chemistry that happens in our body. So if you want to become a dietitian, take science during your 12th. Then there are BSc courses in nutrition and dietetics. There is home science, or you can go for any other applied sciences with chemistry. Then you can opt for post-graduation and masters in nutrition and dietetics. The basic thing that you require is a science, and you require this. You require various courses, not a 3 month or 6 month, but at least 3 years of course with academic internship of 6 months at a registered hospital, working under critical care nutrition. You should know what enteral and parenteral nutrition is. So it is not very easy to be to do dietetics, but yeah, you can do, and you require all of these skills as well. You need to know various languages, because language plays a bigger role while you counsel your patients, and you require patience and listening skills because your patient has a lot to tell you. So yeah, listening skills is one of the most important things. So this is in short what you require to be a dietitian. So we as dietitians have a professional organization by the name Indian Dietetic Association. I am a very active member. Indian Dietetic Association is association of dietitians. We have different chapters in different cities. We do once a year conference, and in the conference we have various doctors from different specialties and dietitians from various dietitians globally speaking and sharing their knowledges on various topics. So that is called IDEACON, Indian Dietetic Association Conference. Next, I am a part of Association of Diabetes Educator. Diabetes Educator is one of the very important persons in a diabetic's life. It is one of that key between a doctor and a diabetic patient. We as a team help a diabetic patient to walk through life. There are various aspects that a doctor doesn't get time to talk to their patient. So we as diabetes educator counsel them regarding how their diet should be, how they should be taking their medicines and other things. So Association of Diabetes Educators is a team of diabetes educators globally. We have conferences, we do various activities under ADE. So I am a member of these two organizations. Thank you. So medicines are for our betterment. As you said that you have headache. So if you have headache, why is the headache? Is it because of acidity, or is it because of stress, or is it because of increased screen time? You need to reciprocate on yourself. If it is because of acidity, you will require a medicine every day, because you are not changing the root cause of your headache. If it is because of acidity, then you are maybe probably keeping a lot of gaps in between your meals, or you are having more than 2 to 3 cups of tea per day. So yes, definitely a lot of medicines do create a problem on your kidney, and many times you don't require those medicines. A small simple changes in your lifestyle by actually improving your water quantity in your diet. Like, a lot of people drink only 4 to 5 glasses of water, which is 1/4 of what you should be drinking. That is 16 glasses of water per day. If you just do this, that you are increasing your water content of the daily diet, you can actually see your acidity will subside. And if your acidity subsides, and if your headache is because of this acidity, it will be gone. So a little tweaks here and there, and you won't require the medicine. But if the headache is because of migraine or some other medical issue, then you might require medicine. But knowing the root cause is very important. I always suggest, please reciprocate, please see what the root cause is, and let food be thy medicine rather than actually taking or gulping down that pill. So that's what my answer to your question was. Pandemic was bad, but it has actually made us learn a lot of things. I personally learned, you know, how important family is. Family, your parents are very important. We usually don't give time to our parents. I would tell 2 years down the lane, when I was working with various hospitals, I used to go at 9, come back at 9, then have my dinner, or do a little bit of watch a little bit of TV, scroll phone, and go off to sleep. No time to talk to your parents. My mother used to tell me, "Are you living in a hostel? You come to eat, you sleep, and you go." There was no family time, no time for your mother, father, discussion about their health and everything. But COVID did make us realize that how important it is to give time to them. They actually made us realize who is very important to you. You know, there was a big bunch of friends, but then the real ones got shut down, come to very little number. Third is one thing that definitely has made a change is people have started realizing that how health is important. One thing that I have come across, as I said before also, that pandemic has changed people's mindset of live and party hard, but they have actually started taking care of their health. I see a number increasing in people doing daily walks, going for running. I have seen people taking care of their diet. I have seen control for immunity. So pandemic did definitely made us realize how important family time is, how important your mother father's health is. One thing that I have come across is pandemic has made people realize health is wealth. आपका बिजनेस चले बिजनेस बंद हो सकता है जॉब जा सकती है बट इफ योर हेल्थ इज गुड इफ यू आर हेल्दी एंड फिट यू कैन एक्चुअली एम्बार्क बैक टू वर्क एंड यू कैन स्टार्ट योर वर्क अगेन यू कैन गेट गो बैक टू योर बिजनेस टाइम यू कैन स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग अप योर बिजनेस फ्रॉम स्क्रैच ओनली इफ यू आर फिट एंड हेल्दी एंड people have started realizing it really because of pandemic they have started taking care of their health which was very 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 important especially in India because people were running towards money like anything I used to see people eating in the morning and then eating at night and between they used to take 20-21 cups of tea this is not how your business is done you're earning for your food and if you're not eating your food right how is it going to help but this scenario has changed and I am so thankful to COVID that it made people realize that health is the only wealth that is so PCOS is a very common condition within females and but it is you know improvable it is recoverable पूरी तरीके से ठीक नहीं होता है बट आप आपका जो PCOS है उसको कंट्रोल में कर सकते हैं राइटली सेड बाय न्यूट्रिशन बाय डाइट एंड एक्सरसाइज यस वेट गेन इज वन ऑफ द साइड इफेक्ट्स और वन ऑफ द मेजर सिम्टम्स ऑफ PCOS बट नीड नॉट बी द केस इन एवरीवन वी हैव सीन पेशेंट्स विद लीन PCOS ऑल्सो लीन इज अ पर्सन हु इज स्लिम and has PCOS. PCOS is an imbalance of three hormones in our body and these hormones if are imbalanced can create problems like weight gain, like infertility. But I have come across people who have actually taken proper medications and tried to change their lifestyles, modified their lifestyles, lost weight, ate good, ate anti-inflammatory foods to lose weight, to actually reduce the inflammation that is caused by PCOS, and a little counseling, a little positivity, they have come a long way. I have seen them actually conceiving and giving birth to little children. So don't worry if you are a PCOS. There you can definitely conceive and you can have a healthy baby. Consult an endocrinologist, consult a qualified dietitian for your diet, do exercise, maintain healthy weight, maintain a healthy lifestyle with a positive attitude. You will definitely see results. I am from Nagpur. I used to live in a building called Chandralok Building. It is in the center and third largest building in Nagpur. We have shifted now, but that building, we have had a lot of memories in that building. We used to celebrate each and every festival. And you know, that building had diversity. We used to celebrate all the religious festivals in each other's home. We used to play a lot. So when we used to play a lot, mummy homework karne ke liye definitely chillati thi, phir jana padta tha. So that is one. Chandralok building has a lot of memories. I have a lot of memories there. Yes, definitely. Papa is one of those people I'm scared of. But not many memories of how, but he has helped me discipline my life in a. In different ways his anger has been one of those memories that I will always keep. If I be put in a time machine, I don't think I would like to change my life in any other way. I am really very, very happy in whatever I am doing and wherever I am. If 3-4 years down the lane, you would have asked me this question, I would have definitely said that if I would have got a time machine, I would have been a doctor. I would have done MBBS. But now I have realized that whatever happens, happens for your better, for your good. And I am really content being a dietitian. I would never want my life in any other way. My work is a fun activity itself because I get to talk a lot of people. One of the best things that I do is talking. I like to socialize with people, know new people, make new friends with new people. So it is one of the fun activities. Secondly, I am an avid reader. I read one book per week. And it is one of the things that I have tried to maintain. I actually decide upon reading 2 pages every day, but it is never 2 pages. It always increases. But reading is one of those things which is the most fun thing that I do every day. So yeah, reading is something that has been with me since forever. I have been a born leader because when I was during school or school times also, I used to take managerial roles, you know, we used to plan those annual concerts. I used to be one of the members of the organizing committee, having 2 to 3 people, ordering them do this, that, do that. So, and with experience, the skills have upskilled, they have become more better, but I feel I have been a born leader. I have pursued what I have studied. A lot of people study different and do something different. So what I think is my experience as well as my education are part and parcel of each other. Without education, I wouldn't have got the experience that I have. And without experience, I wouldn't have actually, did better in my education. In my educational front, my academics, I am still learning. I keep doing various certificate courses to actually upskill my knowledge, to keep myself updated with the recent researches. So, you know, this with part and parcel, I experience a particular disease condition which I might have not heard before. Then I Google it, I read about it, I research about it. If I see a course, I do that certificate course. So you know how part and parcel it is. So yeah, I give credit to both of them for my education as well as experience. I dedicate this song to my patients, my family, everyone, my friends, and here it is. Please bear with my singing. Koi kahe kehta rahe kitna bhi humko diwana hum logo ki thokar mein hai ye zamana bigde duniya bigadne bhi do lade duniya ladne bhi do jhagde duniya jhagadne bhi do ab apne dil mein gao duniya toote rutne do koi kahe kehta rahe kitna bhi humko diwana. Thanks to everyone for patience watching and listening the video. If you like it, if I have inspired you in any way, please comment, share, and let people know my story. Thank you so much. If you want to listen to more motivational, inspirational stories, please come on the platform called WorkMob and listen to your stories, get inspired somehow. If I can, definitely you can. So do join in. थैंक यू
दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे थे एक क्लिनिकल डाइटिशियन मालविका फुलवानी के जीवन की कहानी इनकी अपनी जुबानी। ऐसी ही प्रेरक कहानियां रोजाना सुनने के लिए चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन जरूर दबाएं। और दोस्तों, अगर आज की ये कहानी आपको पसंद आई है तो इसे लाइक, कमेंट और शेयर करें। जी हाँ, WorkMob आपको दे रहा है एक सुनहरा मौका अपने जीवन के अनुभव, अपने विचार हमारे साथ साझा करने का। तो आइए और जुड़िए आप भी इस मुहिम में हमारे साथ और सुनाइए अपनी कहानी देशवासियों को। लेट्स इंस्पायर टुगेदर, इफ वी कैन इंडिया कैन। जी हाँ दोस्तों, आपकी कहानी ले आएगी लोगों के जीवन में आशा की एक नई किरण। तो आइए और दीजिए इस मुहिम में हमारा साथ और अपनी कहानी से देशवासियों को दीजिए एक नई प्रेरणा। जी हाँ, फिलहाल वक्त उचला है आप सभी से इजाजत लेने का, लेकिन बहुत जल्द एक बार फिर होंगे हाजिर एक नई कहानी के साथ। तब तक के लिए आप बने रहिए हमारे साथ, देखते रहिए कहानियों का हमारा एक खास कार्यक्रम और लीजिए हर नई कहानी से हर दिन एक नई और सच्ची प्रेरणा। नमस्कार।